started playing football in refugee camp in Denmark. It was kind of destiny, I would say, because there was a football club beside the refugee camp, and I used to watch other kids play football every day. And one day I gathered my courage and went and asked the coach if I could join. And from then on, yeah, I think it became an obsession, trained every day or played every day. And now we're here.
Wonderful. But just explain as well, you were born in Afghanistan. It's not that usual, I don't think, is it, for women to play football or girls to play football in Afghanistan. So how was that a more peaceful period in Afghanistan's history?
I was born in Afghanistan, and the stuff that I do remember, the period of time I remember, wasn't always the most peaceful time. It was during the war, and that was also one of the reasons we had to leave the country, because as a female, as a girl, it was hard for us to stay there because there's so many rules that made it extremely difficult for girls and women to function in society. And football, yeah, that was not a thing you could do at that point.
And tell me about the influence of your father in your life, Nadia.
My father had a huge influence on my life. You know, he was the first person who introduced me to to football. Like, I wouldn't say we played football, but he was like, you're not supposed to play dodgeball with a football. It's supposed to be kicked and, you know, try to juggle. So I kind of knew what football was, but never really played it. That's until we arrived to Denmark and I saw girls playing football. And yeah, I got obsessed with the game.
Okay, and today you play for Denmark, but ultimately Denmark isn't in the World Cup. How does that make you feel, Nadia?
Yeah, it sucks, to be honest. Obviously devastated that we're not going to be part of the World Cup. I think this is going to be one of the biggest World Cups so far. You know, the women's game has grown so much, and I think we belong to, like, among the best in the world. But unfortunately, we didn't prove it. And that's part of the game. You know, sometimes you win, sometimes you don't, and there's always a next time, I guess.